GIFs, or is it GIFs? Either way, today we're going to take an in-depth look at making these in Final Cut Pro with a custom Apple Compressor preset. Hey guys, what's up? This is Serge, and welcome back to my channel. Using GIFs is a great way to spice up your website, promote your content, or step up your Twitter game, especially when these are set up to loop or play over and over. GIFs can easily be made by using an online service free of charge, but if you own Final Cut Pro and Apple's Compressor, you can add a custom export preset to export GIFs directly from Final Cut Pro. First, to make a GIF, you need to start with a video clip. Theoretically, you can make it as long as you want, but generally GIFs are meant to be nice and short, around 2 to 6 seconds long. Once you have your clip, first let's take a look at Compressor's built-in presets. In the top right corner, hit the share button and select Add Destination. Double-click the compressor settings and from the built-in folder, select Motion Graphics. From here, you can select Animated Image Large or Animated Image Small. Add either one or both of these to your share presets. Close your Destinations window, hit the Share button again, and select your share preset for your GIF. Selecting Animated Image Large will export a GIF file that's 640 pixels wide by 360 pixels tall and is optimized for best quality playback. A 4-second video exported as a GIF in this format will be approximately 16 megabytes. Animated Image Small preset is 428 pixels wide by 240 pixels tall and is played back only at 15 frames per second. This format is optimized for messaging and websites, and the same 4-second video file is only approximately 4 megabytes, considerably smaller than Animated Image Large. You can also make your own custom preset for exporting GIFs from Final Cut Pro. To make a custom setting, open up Compressor, click on the Settings and Locations button to open up a sidebar, and in the bottom left corner, click on the plus sign and select New Setting. From the Format drop-down menu, select Image Sequence and give it a name. Now over in the Inspector, from the Image Type drop-down menu, select GIF and select the Animated checkbox. Next, you can choose whether your playback will be continuous, or you can choose to stop playback after a selected number of plays. Selecting Continuous will loop your GIF playback over and over. This is great for cinemagraphs, where you can get continuous motion in your image. Next, in the Video tab of the Inspector, you can select a video resolution and playback frame rate. Selecting Automatic will keep the same frame rate as your source clip. Next, close Compressor and go back to Final Cut Pro. To export your GIF by using your custom preset, once again, hit the Share button and select Add Destination. Double-click Compressor Settings, and your preset that you just made will be in your custom folder. Hit OK and close your settings window. Now hit the Share button again and select your new export preset to export your video clip as a GIF. So next time you need to upload a still image to your website or you need some promotion material for your latest video to share on social media, consider making a GIF. It's not going to be ideal every time, but the small file size of GIFs may be exactly what you need. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more Final Cut Pro tutorials. New videos uploaded weekly, so turn on notifications so you don't miss them. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you back next week.